Hello everybody, a friendly tree here, finally back to uploading some videos. Well, sorry it's been a while, but I've been on holiday, and I've also been attending BAM 10, Battle Arena Melbourne, one of the biggest fighting game events in Australia. Had a lot of fun. So I've been pretty busy, mostly with personal things. But anyway, back to upload some videos and discuss a few things as requested. So, people have been asking for me to just post some videos that don't include Instant While Standing 1. So I thought I'd do that today. We're going to do them against Zhao Yu, just because she's a smaller character, so a lot of the time certain combos may not hit on the smaller characters. Can also affect the larger characters too, so it's good to test these on a variety of different size characters. Anyway, when I'm practicing combos, I like to practice them on Zhao Yu, just because she's often the hardest to land them on, or one of the hardest. We'll go to an infinite stage. I'll set up my inputs. So I realise people were asking for non-instant while standing one combos, mostly because, well, they're difficult. So it's because of the difficulty in doing the while standing one combos. So instant while standing, so in these situations, I will not be suggesting any combos where you have to do a while standing one instantly like that. So not mid combo, not any time except for when you might be transitioning into it easily, such as a size 1 forward while standing 1, or a downfall 3-2 forward while standing 1. This also means that I won't be suggesting that you do them after a tailspin, so you won't see me suggesting doing anything like that, for example. Alright, well, to start with, I'm just going to go through some of the main normal hit launches. I'm not going to talk about counter hit ones, and I'm probably not going to include all the normal hit, but I'll give you an example of some of the combos. So, looking at down forward 2, I've got two combos I can suggest that don't use while standing 1. So, the first one I'm going to suggest is doing a down forward 2 into an up forward 4, then an up forward 3, then a down forward 1, then a forward 2-1-4, then after the tailspin while running 1 plus 2. Now there's a trick with this, and you'll notice if I just try and do it normally, up forward 4, up forward 3, down forward 1, it won't connect. So what you actually need to do is you either need to delay the up forward 4 a little bit, or you need to do a micro dash between the up forward 4 and the up forward 3. So I typically like to do the micro dash, so up forward 4, forward forward, up forward 3, up forward 4, forward forward, up forward 3, there you go. But you can see that's quite tricky, and that's why I'm also going to suggest this other combo, up forward 4, down forward 1, down forward 3, 2, forward, into while standing 1, 1 plus 2. So up forward 4, down forward 1, down forward 3, 2, through forward, while standing 1, 1 plus 2, while running 1 plus 2. So of course you're not actually doing the motion there, you're transitioning with forward, then just pressing 1, 1 plus 2. Likewise, I suggest doing the same thing off back 1 plus 4. So back 1 plus 4, up forward 4, down forward 1, down forward 3, 2 forward, while standing 1, 1 plus 2. While running 1 plus 2. Okay, straightforward enough I hope. Into while standing 2. So off a while standing 2, you're not going to be able to get an up forward 4. So you'll see here, you don't recover fast enough, they don't get launched high enough. So in this case, what I'm going to suggest you do is you omit the up forward 4 and just go straight for the up forward 3. And do the same combos we're doing just before. So up forward 3, down forward 1, forward 2, 1, 4. Oh, sorry, we were doing up forward 3, down forward 1, down forward 3, 2, forward, while standing 1, 1, 2. Oh, let's do that again. Alright, now up forward 1, a few different things you can do with up forward 1. What I like to do is I like to do an up forward 3. So what you do is you you do the up forward 1 and then you dash forward. So up forward 1, dash forward, up forward 3. Then you can get it down forward 1, down forward 3, 2 forward while standing 1 plus 2. Or what I'm actually going to suggest you do is do a forward 2, 1, 4. Then end with quarter circle forward 4, 2, 3. So it's going to look like this. So up forward 1, up forward 3, down forward 1, up forward 1, 4-3. Gotta think. I'm trying to read these combos and I'm getting mixed up. Here we go. I'm suggesting that because it's high damage without while standing one and it's wall carry. Another common thing people do is they crouch cancel and do a down forward 3-2, but this is more for a route when you're doing while standing one. So you go crouch cancel, sidestep right, like that. Yeah. Okay, next one I want to look at is up forward 2-1. Now up forward 2-1 is an interesting one. I really like this move. I mean, it's probably Nina's best launcher, I think. Just in the sense it's 18 frame, hit confirmable, and it leaves them in that bound state, which gives you a lot of opportunities. In particular, it gives you time to do a sidestep 1. So typically you'd sidestep right during Nina's combos, but in this one you sidestep down first if you're doing this combo I'm suggesting. If you do a double sidestep 1 combo, you have to sidestep down at the beginning regardless of what side you're on. So it's going to look like this. You're going to do sidestep down, sidestep 1, then back sway, then sidestep up, sidestep 1, back sway into an up forward 4. Then a down forward 3-2 forward while standing 1-1+2. And it's going to look like this. At 70 damage. That only works off up forward 2-1. So even though there are other moves that you can get a sidestep 1 off, they're going to push back too far, so you can't get that. So if you don't want to do the double sidestep 1, a much easier combo you can do is you do go for the sidestep right. So you do an up forward 2-1, sidestep right 1 back, up forward 4, down forward 3-2 forward while standing 1-1+2. So let me show you that. Screwing up my wall running. There you go, 3 points less damage. And the thing about this is, like I mentioned, you can't do the double sidestep one off like a down back 3+4. It whiffs. Or off a quarter circle back 4. Or off a low parry, but we'll come back to that later. So off a down back 3+4, just do the other juggle I suggested. So sidestep right 1, back sway, up foot 4, down foot 3, 2 forward, while standing 1-1+2. And same with quarter circle back 4. Oh, sorry. Oh my god. Yeah. Alright. Now on to quarter circle forward 4-2. So, I mean, this is the main situation I think of using this as well. One out of a forward sway, or two if you see like an Asuka doing a parry. Because it's a knee starter, or if you're expecting an attack reversal for whatever reason. So quarter circle forward 4-2, it floats, and it doesn't give you many options to do. So you'll see a jab whiff, can get a down 4-1 for very bad scaling and very bad damage, or you can get a down forward 1. So for example, an easy combo you could do is down forward 1, and then the same ender we keep doing. Or, the thing is, ending in while running 1+2, you don't get any sort of wall carry. So another option you could do is down forward 1, forward 2-1-4, quarter circle forward 4-2-3. Same damage, but wall carry. Yeah. Alright, next thing I want to look at is sidestep 2. So sidestep 2. This one's interesting because depending on the direction you sidestep, because of the axis it puts the character on, you get different combos. So sidestep right, you can do an up forward 4 into a down forward 1, down forward 3-2 forward while standing 1-1+2, such as this. Oh, it does hit. Yeah. But if I try and do that sidestep left, down forward 1 whips. Against most characters, you can actually just do a jab there, a 1 instead of a down forward 1, but against Ling, doesn't work. So again, I mean, what I'm suggesting you do is just do the jab combo, which is that same string that we did off up forward one with the crouch cancel. It's down forward 3-2, sidestep right one, back sway. Then we're going to do a forward sway into a while standing 1-1+2 for the tailspin. So down forward 3-2, sidestep right one, forward while standing 1-1+2. And then we're going to actually do a while running. For some reason, I'm not getting those very well today. There we go. So a fair bit less damage, but at least it's consistent. And that's consistent on both sides. Except on this side, you have to sidestep left and do a forward sway. You get the idea. Okay, next one I want to talk about is back one. So, I mean, back one isn't a move I ever really use. When I do, it's on accident. Example, I'm blocking. I try and do a 1-2, like a 10-frame punish, or a 1-4 10-frame punish, and it comes out as a back one. Then I usually get launched, so yeah. Or if I'm doing a back 1+4, I accidentally piano the inputs. Anyway, should you land it, should you deliberately do it, or non-deliberately do it, she doesn't get much off it. So what I'd suggest doing is just the down 4-1 into a down 4-3-2, forward while standing 1-1+2, such as this. Running is not my friend today. Not at all. There we go. Okay, and forward 2-1-4. So if the first hit whiffs and the second two connect, it becomes a launcher. So I guess I'll include this. What I normally do is quarter circle forward 1, down forward 3-2, forward while standing 1. Well, while standing one, quarter circle forward. Oh wow. There we go. Quarter circle forward, 4-2-3 ender. The last thing I'll talk about is we'll look at the low parry. So most of her low parry damage does come from while standing one. While standing ones, but yeah, we're not doing that today. So what can we do? We've got a few different options. First off, talking about that double sidestep one, it doesn't work. But you can just do the sidestep one combo we talked about earlier. 47 damage, that's not too bad for a low parry. Or if you're feeling very brave with your inputs, you could do a quarter circle forward one combo. So three in a row. One in a row, two in a row, none in a row, three in a row, 50 damage. Oh boy, well I've screwed up a lot of inputs here, but you've been able to see them, you've been able to get an understanding of them, like an idea of what you can do if you don't want to do the while standing one combos. I do suggest that you learn how to do the while standing one combos, because they're very valuable, they become much more rewarding, and I also suggest instead of going for this high damage all the time, I do think you should be going for wall carry, and on an infinite stage you should be going for just mid-screen oki as possible. Please check out my other videos with suggestions on how you can do this. I actually have another video on combo composition which goes a bit more into depth about how to structure a combo. Anyway, let me know if there's anything else you'd like me to do. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Thank you very much.